Two items. One, I'd like to acknowledge that the mayor got his diploma on Saturday, I believe. I made it through the executive MBA program at NYU. I think the council and the city will benefit. And I think it's admirable. I'm trying to think of a diplomatic way to say it. It would be difficult to get through all that accounting and financing if I was more than one standard deviation above the average age of the students. And I think it's very admirable. Second, not quite as happy a note, but I just want to talk about something that's coming up. We're going to have to deal with what to do with this $30 million for the OG&E substation. Two events happened last Thursday, which are seemingly unrelated, but are very related. And I think that that's asking the MAPS Advisory Committee to give an opinion as to what to do with that $30 million. And Gary, I think, wisely indicated that they don't have all the facts to make that recommendation. And then there was a post-Ed Kelly editorial in the Oklahoman that was fairly strong in some of its opinions. I don't want to fight with the Oklahoman, but I think, and I don't want to inflame tensions, but I think this goes to the core of the issue. I think we're making progress, and I think there's value in vetting this. You know you're close to the target when you start drawing heavy fire, and I think that one reason for the ire in that editorial may be that if we continue down this line of thought, if we continue this discussion about whether the public was fully informed and whether the vote constitutes a bond and what do we do with this $30 million because what was promised during campaign literature, I think that that discussion is going to lead back to the Oklahoman. And an example would be the OG&E substation. You know, I was confused because the mayor would talk at that the workshop, but there didn't seem to be an interest in discussing this substation before the MAPS 3 vote, and I didn't understand what that meant. And then just kind of going back, there's a blogger named Doug Loudenbach, and looking at before that, he went to the mayor's office, he talked to David Holt. There was a frank and open discussion about what the $30 million would be required to move that substation, and Doug Loudenbach puts it in writing in his blog, and that's the only place I can find it in writing. But it clearly was out there, and Doug Loudenbach is exchanging emails, he's friends with all the journalists at the Oklahoman, they all knew about this issue. They brought it to their new staff to do a story. Any objective third party would come to the conclusion that that's a story worth vetting before the MAPS 3 vote about you've got to move. There's a OG&E substation at Southwest 4th and Robinson. You're gonna put a park there. You're potentially going to put a convention center there. That needs to be vetted. But the story, if you believe the account of these journalists, was killed. All the Oklahoman had to do was print that story and vet that in the public, and we wouldn't be faced with, you know, did somebody say this? Did we have this discussion or not have this discussion? And the preposterous predicament of having the MAPS Advisory Committee try and weigh down on this. Again, it's to learn from the past and to apply these lessons to the future. I'd invite the viewer to watch this YouTube video. It's a Fox News report 6 days before the MAPS 3 election. It's called "Did OPUBCO Forget About Ethics?" That's a YouTube video that gives this Fox report, and it talks about some of the problems that we had where a memo offering a paid day off for OPUBCO employees to go campaign for MAPS 3 was very controversial in the journalistic world. That we got into the same situation we talked about 2 weeks ago where we had the publisher of the Oklahoman, also the chairman of the Oklahoma City Chamber, and also responsible for the MAPS 3 campaign. Who would know the results of the Convention Sports and Leisure study, but that also was not allowed to be published. And then in that report, Gil Hensley, the FOP president, was saying members of the media had made clear to him that there was clear direction what stories would and would not allow to be printed. And he I think he caught some flack at the time. But when I talk to multiple journalists, they're all independently telling me the same thing he was saying then, is that stories are systematically being killed at the Oklahoma that are and are not allowed to be vetted. An internationally known journalist who recently talked with these journalists and heard some of the same things said, Ed, if what these journalists are saying is true, it rises to the level of scandal. The take-home point is that if there's a rationalization on utilitarian grounds that withholding information from the public is for the greater good of the public, that's a slippery slope, that's a dangerous slope. Because tomorrow, someone else with a wildly different agenda could use the same rationalization to very destructive means. We need the Oklahoman and all the journalists to protect us. They are the fourth pillar of government. And any threat to our representative democracy, it's their job to protect us from, whether that's plutocratic, theocratic, whatever. So the implications for MAPS 3, again, becomes one of legitimacy. The argument, oftentimes with righteous indignation, is that we have this contract with the voters that the convention center, for example, has to be $280 million because that's what was on the campaign literature. If not everything was vetted, if information was withheld, then that you have a problem with legitimacy. Oklahoman believes I have an obsession with the convention center. That's not true. I have an obsession with the process. And we can learn from the mistakes that were made, and we can apply them, and we can improve upon it in the future. Thank you.
All right. Gary?